Hello mortals. As you doubtlessly know by now, there are plenty of threats to the existence of humanity and North Korea, the best Korea. But there is something that even our great leader Kim Jong-un will not be able to stop. That something is a vacuum cleaner that deteriorates over time. At least that's the first thing I imagined when I heard of vacuum decay. In order to understand it, you need to know what energy levels are. For example, when you are working or learning something useful, you are in your highest energy state. Yet you always strive to go lower, or as you call it, getting lazier, say, by sitting on the couch or playing video games. And you might think this is the laziest you can get, when in reality you can go even further, say, by sleeping, which is the minimum energy level possible. Okay, that was a stupid analogy. Better think of a ball on the top of a steep hill. It is very unstable, having a lot of potential energy, it wishes to get rid of it, by going on a more stable surface. Once it is there, the ball is considered stable. However, it may turn out that there is an even lower and more stable level, making the current position metastable. And this is pretty much how the energy fields in the universe work. It is believed that all of them, the electron field, the photon field, the graviton field, all of them, exist at the minimum energy level, making them truly stable. However, some research shows that there is something wrong with the Higgs field, the one that gives the particles mass.
I'm tired of you stealing my life! I'm tired of you making me feel if I'm good or bad!
And that something might mean the end of everything. Those calculations suggest that the Higgs field might not be at a minimum energy level, creating what is known as a false vacuum. It would also make the field metastable. Which is kind of stable, but if someone were to give the ball a small push, it would fly off the edge. That small push could be a powerful enough excitation of the field, like an incredibly powerful supernova, or a very energetic particle collision. And if the Higgs field is to change its value, all hell will break loose. The disturbance point would convert all the nearby space to the same energy level. That would mean that a sphere of true vacuum would start expanding at the speed of light in all the directions. The vacuum inside the sphere is at a lower energy state than the one outside, meaning that the surplus of energy will be concentrated in the walls of the sphere. Everything that comes in contact with it will be annihilated. It's like a factory restore of the universe. What makes it even better is that the universe inside the death sphere will have different laws of physics. And we don't know which ones. The new laws might not allow atoms to form. There might be new types of particles that we can't even imagine. Maybe if gravity were to exist, it would only work when you look down? It all depends on the properties of the new Higgs field. Oh, did I also mention that the deadly sphere expands at the speed of light? And you know what also travels at the speed of light? Yeah. Light. And you know what that means? There is no way of seeing it coming until it's right in your face, literally. It will continue to expand, until it engulfs the entire universe, allowing for a new one to be born inside it, one which may not even be suitable for life. Or if it is, it will leave no trace of previous false vacuum decays, so even if some civilizations may evolve in that new universe, they might only guess if such an event took place. Who knows? Maybe it has already happened, and the Big Bang was in reality a vacuum decay. But you shouldn't worry. First of all, it is impossible to prevent such a thing, your worries won't help. Second of all, the death sphere is expanding at only the speed of light. And I say only because that's not really much considering that the universe might be infinite in size. If it happens far away from us, there is a good chance that because of the inflation of the universe it will never even reach us. But you know what can reach you? Skynet.